My 30-year-old maple trees have large sections of leaves that are turning brown, drying up, and dying. It is happening over the majority of the tree. I tried checking for verticillium wilt by scraping the bark off some branches, but I don't think that was it. The trees get watered weekly when I water the lawn using irrigation water that can sometimes be salty and dirty. What might be stressing my maple trees? The irrigation water, not enough water, lack of nutrients, or possible disease. Mm-hmm. How can I help them? And this is Wendy from South Jordan, Utah. Okay. So how can we help Miss Wendy?
Well, from the pictures that we were looking at that she sent in along with that question, we were kind of leaning towards a leaf scorch type situation.
Definitely.
And basically what that means when you have a plant that's suffering from leaf scorch that's not being induced by a disease like bacterial disease or a virus, general leaf scorch has to do with the uptake of water and the loss of water from the leaf surface. So that leaf surface, and think of a maple leaf, they're large.
Yeah,
and so we've got a largely surface area there, and it's losing water right through respiration as that plant is recovering, and it just can't take up enough water to replace the water that's leaving from that leaf. And so then you get scorch, usually from the margins of the leaf inwards. And the veins will look okay, but then all that material, depending on how severe the situation is, you will have more or less margin of like necrosis, right? Like brownness around the edge of that leaf. And I think that we're kind of leaning towards that, just the availability of water and the ability of the plant to take it up. It was on a pretty narrow strip of ground with impervious surface on both sides, road, sidewalk. So that would probably be my first go-to.
That's definitely mine. Yeah, definitely environmental stresses, heat. Of course, wind plays a factor in that as well.
They're in Utah,
right?
So we've got some exposure.
For
definitely
sure.
Going to have the high light and heat factor there.
That's
in the
sure.
summer.
Mm-hmm. And she did mention with the irrigation water, salty and dirty. That salt can build up over time.
It can accumulate in those soils because they don't get a lot of rain like we do here.
Right.
So they're not getting the rain to flush the salts out of the soil. So, I mean, it could definitely, be an option or a contributing factor.
That's right.
But I feel like the causation is just the ability of the plant to take up water.
I would agree with that. Make sure you're watering deeply.
Yeah.
Deeply, okay? Most people, when they irrigate their lawn, they're thinking, your grass is pretty much the same water I can use for.
And they
have
some restrictions on irrigation in Utah too. So, I mean, you have to consider where you are.
That's right. Hope you enjoyed the video. We would love to get more questions from you. So be sure to leave us some comments.